1, 2, 3 o'clock, 4 o'clock, rock. 5, 6, 7 o'clock, 8 o'clock, rock. 9, 10, 11 o'clock, 12 o'clock, rock, we're going to rock.
Around. My guest tonight is Norm Bland. Welcome to the program, Norm.
Thank you, Cecile.
Tell me all about yourself, because I haven't heard of you a lot over the years, because when we're playing ourselves, you don't get to hear people. What got you started and what makes Norm who he is?
Well, Cecile, it is sort of a long story, but I guess I owe sort of my career to a guy called Neville Wilkins. And you all know Neville Wilkins.
He's
a good man, and he's still blowing his trumpet.
And, I'd just like to qualify that. He's wonderful on the trumpet.
He's wonderful. He's still blowing his trumpet, probably more ways than one. However, and way back, I think about 1962, 1963, I got a call from my friend Pete Sidry, unfortunately, who's passed away. He actually asked me if I was interested in singing in a band, because we were jamming at his place and we used to have a lot of fun listening to the Goon Show, and as we did. And he asked me to go along, and I went along to the audition, and Neville Wilkins was there, and Les Wilkins, his brother, both competent musicians. Les, great sax player. And I did my first number in the band was 24 Hours from Tulsa, Gene Pitney. And I did that, and I got the job, basically. So Neville Wilkins, he helped me get on my way.
What did it feel like when you got your first job?
Oh, mate, it was just so good. Yeah, so good.
That wonderful feeling.
It really hasn't changed.
No.
Yeah.
Well, let's go a bit earlier than that. Yep. How did you get introduced to music? When you were a boy, what sort of schools influenced you, and how did it happen?
Well, I told you before, I had a wonderful life at Christchurch West High School. I mean, not many children cry when they leave school. I mean, I did. I mean, that's unusual. Simply because in the last 2 years of high school, I was in the Gilbert and Sullivan operas with Miss Osborne. And, of course, I had key roles in both those operas. I was very lucky. And also, I was also in charge of the school cadets.
So how did you actually get into the singing side of things? Well, even earlier than that, were you always singing, or you just liked the acting careers, or what?
Oh, well, it does go back. Yes, you're right. Run a boarding house on Strickland Street. Now, if you know Brian Ringrose, everyone knows Brian Ringrose. Well, he used to sit out on the porch at Strickland Street with all these boarders, and he used to play his guitar, and that's where he learnt to play guitar. Now, at the same time, I also learnt to play guitar, and I think the first song I ever sung on guitar was Let's Go on a Moonlight Swim. Then I started playing guitar, and then, of course, I went to high school, and I'm a tenor baritone. I've got a part as Coco on the Mikado, and, you know, that just set me up. It was just so good.
Loads of fun, Gilbert and Sullivan.
It was, yeah.
Yes.
And Margaret Osborne was just an amazing lady at Christchurch West High School. And I left in December 1963. And as I said, when I went out into Stewart Street, I just about cried. I didn't want to go.
You mentioned before we came on air that you loved dressing up in uniforms, and you you were in the cadets, and you did rifle shooting and all sorts of things.
That was another reason why. I mean, I had two great things to do at high school. One of them was the school cadets. And even now, I run into people in the street. You were that awful SSM, you know. You were that awful man who used to strop me up on the parade ground. Well, I was only 5'6", and I used to love it. I used to, it was enjoyable.
Your moment of glory.
I must admit. And that, of course, and the music, hey.
I bet your boots were the shiniest boots in the school.
My goodness me, Dion, they probably were, yeah.
Yes. That's a big stretch, isn't it, from opera to pop?
Yep.
So take us through that journey a wee bit.
Well,
how did you progress from that to that?
Well, as I said, I did my first gig with a fella called Peter Sidry, who's now passed away. We had, I think, a 15-watt amplifier. Yeah. I would have been probably 18.
Okay.
Yeah, and we went on a car rally, and we ended up at the Mocha Carrara Hall. I think I must have sung Travelling Light about 10 times. The car rally people were so impressed, they gave us 10 shillings each, so that was the introduction. And then, as I said, I used to stay down at Pete Sidra's place, and we used to have a lot of fun, listen to the Goons records, and play guitar and that. And then, as I said, he introduced me to Neville Wilkins. I was with the Viscounts for well over 2 years.
What sort of places would you be playing at?
Well, it was all gig stuff, you know. It was weddings and, of course,
working, 21st,
yeah, big social events. And
weren't they great?
Oh, they were beaut. The only thing was, though, Cecile, and I must admit, that the smoking, it was awful. You know, you'd be on the stage and the smoke would be going up your nose and your
sore throat
and your eyes would be watering and it wasn't nice. And
but the supper made up for it.
Yes. the Lemingtons.
Dion's favourite.
And the custard squares and the potato top pies.
And, I used to love the pavlova cake.
Pavlova. Not quite into that sort of stuff, Cecile, yes. But I used to love my potato top pies.
One night we were at a family function and Dion made a beeline for the chocolate Lemingtons with the cream, and he grabbed hold of it and he pulled and...
No. I squeezed it to see if it was fresh, and it was lovely, and I bit it very quickly and pulled it, but they had put foam rubber, there was chocolate around it, and the stuff. And I'll tell you what, one of the guys didn't know about it and bit it, and his false teeth
came out.
When we were with the Viscounts, we, of course, you guys were due to leave the Copper Cat.
That's right.
Just over the road here. And at that time, Adam Fakadovich was looking for a group, and unfortunately, five of us pulled away from the Viscounts. And of course, Neville Wilkins, obviously, it broke his heart because, you know, the five
But
guys,
you've got to progress.
Yes,
that,
exactly.
That happens.
Yeah.
People and move different directions.
We do. And that's when we formed Rhythm and Bland, and that's when we took over from you guys. And we were up there, I think, for around about 18 months, nearly 2 years. But, oh, the smoke, Cecile, Deal, mate. It was horrendous, wasn't it?
You could never wear your clothes twice.
No.
You had to take everything out and it wash just, it. It was just terrible.
Yeah, but it was an amazing place, you know. But then, after that, when we finished at the Copper Cat, I think Don Clarkson rung me because Dixon McIver, great singer, they had just started up at the Plaza Lounge in the, you know, the old Plaza Theatre and the United Service. They needed a vocalist pretty quickly, so I went in and I auditioned and I got the job, and we were there, the Village Gate. We were there for nearly 5 years.
Village Gate, that's
right. Village
they
Gate.
Played out at the Marine Hotel in Sumner when we had them.
Well, yeah, I was with them from 67 to, I think, early 72, and we had George Drayton on keyboards, we had Dave Cox on drums, and we had Don Clarkson on lead and bass, and myself. It was just a four-piece band, and George used to play keyboards and play bass, and Don used to play bass and guitar, so they could interchange, which was great.
I'm not quite certain of when we had the Marine Hotel in Sumner, but I think it was probably about, was it 70 or 75?
Yeah.
Yeah. No, 1970.
Yeah. Somewhere we might have played out there occasionally.
Yes, you did.
But before that, our drummer was a guy called Paul Humphreys. The nicest thing about the Plaza Lounge was we used to finish at 10 o'clock, pack up our gear and go to another gig. And that was tough. We used to, load up my Mark 1 Zephyr. And
you had one of those too.
Yes,
did you?
I did. Did you have one?
Yes, I did.
Most unstable car on the road. God, the suspension was awful.
But they looked great.
Oh, they did. Yes. We were heroes.
Yes.
Anyhow, we'd load our gear up and we'd have a gig out at Lincoln, a wild hock evening. You know, those days, the wine we had was what? Cold duck and hock.
Oh, yes.
McWilliams Marque Vouet. Mate, wasn't that exciting?
You bring back memories for us too,
oh, yeah.
Because we did the hotel circuits in those early days after the Copper Cat and all of that, and we also went at times after the hotel circuits out to somewhere else to a private gig or a club function or something, and you really thought nothing of it.
No, you didn't.
Which meant you had to pack all your gear up and put it in your cars and unpack it and put it out and then unpack it again and take it to the new place. It was amazing what we did.
Yeah. Well, I had, I was 9.5 stone, had lots of hair.
Again.
Yes.
For those of you who just joined us, we're actually talking to Norm Bland, and he's keeping us amused with some of his off-the-cuff comments.
Oh, dear. It's been so much fun. And to be able to come back into it, in 1976, I actually retired out of show business because my business was up and running in 1977.
And your business was what?
Independent Customs and Freight Brokers.
That's different?
Limited, yes. I help importers and exporters. So that's my business, and there's three of us, and it, you know, it's been good to me over the years, and we've had downers and like everyone else.
So but, basically at that time, your last group was with the Village Gate,
and then a group called Notation.
Oh, Notation, yes.
And Notation, and you might remember Larry Mackay, Page One.
Yes,
that's right.
Then we had a little group together called Answer, and then I think my last group was a group called Eden, which was an absolute disaster.
We've
got to strike it once in a while.
But the crazy thing is, you did an interview with Peter Soudan, you know, ex-Max Merritt drummer. Well, I just couldn't imagine a better drummer than Pete Soudan.
Yes, well, we think he's great too. Yeah.
The interesting thing is that Dion and I started as singers in a band, which was around about a five-piece band. And then we gradually worked our way down to a trio. And I played keyboards, Dion played bass, and we always had a drummer. And we've had some great drummers over the years, and even one we had from the Hollies. That was Peter Heather, and he had such a huge drum set.
A double drum kit that we couldn't get on stage.
We couldn't get on stage with him. Yes, he was fascinating because he had a little wee mini car with two big Great Danes, and himself was 6 feet tall.
And the drums. My goodness. My family were growing up. I've got three wonderful children.
Adults now.
Adults, yeah. Angela, Brendan and Michael, and they're just wonderful, wonderful children. The amazing thing was Peter Soudan and me, we play golf together on Wednesday, and we'd been tire-kicking the idea of getting into a group again. Well, it took us 2 years, basically. We'd be going around the golf course. He'd be tapping his hands on my golf cart, and I'd be singing Gene Pitney, and Johnny East, who we play with, he'd be harmonising, and all of a sudden we'd hear right across the 18th green, "Shut up." But it was true. And then I got a ring from Pete Soudan, and he said, "Norm," he says, we have formed a five-piece band, and it comprised of Pete Soudan, of course, Don Mills on keyboards, Brian Ringrose, Jimmy Mills, Pete Soudan, Don Mills, Jimmy, and of course Trevor Wright. They formed this show band, and then, hey bingo, we were into the big gigs, and we've had four sellout gigs at the Richmond Club with guest singers, myself.
Peter must have something because he enticed Dion and I.
Yeah, it was great.
And we thoroughly enjoyed it, didn't we?
Yes, we had a good time.
Yeah, well, we always, as I said, it's a great concept, and to have the live band and my own one-man band show now called Rhythm and Blend. Isn't that strange?
I wonder how that happened. It doesn't require too much of a stretch of the imagination.
Well, I got into this electronic gear, all the new stuff, and it's just amazing, and I paid for my songs, and I probably spent about $14,000 worth of gear.
You spent a fortune on it in those days.
Duplicated gear, and it's really going well now, so it's a resurgence. It's wonderful.
But I think you really epitomise in some of the things you've been saying that to go from being the solo with the electronic gear behind him and then to get into a big band piece with them, you can't beat that.
No, the adrenaline.
Dion and I found it very freeing to be able to get out from behind our musical instruments and just to sing, and that gives an enjoyment that we thoroughly enjoyed. And we're looking forward to joining you all at the Christchurch Cathedral on the 29th and 30th of September.
Oh, that's going to be a gas.
And it is, I think. There's a great deal of interest, and there's going to be a lot of fun. And that's the whole operation. Yeah. It's fun.
Yeah, for sure. Oh, I mean, the artists who are going to be there, it's just great. All the vigilante guys and all the bands that were around then, they're all going to be
there.
And they're
coming from all over Australia and around New Zealand, aren't they?
Yes, I think the Downbeats. I've got the list at work of all the people who will be performing.
Well, it's quite fascinating, Norm, because we've been running 50 plus and loving it radio programs since about the 14th of October last year.
Right.
And I could just about say that almost everyone, apart from four or five, that have been on that program as a musician entertainer will probably be involved in one or other of these bands or singing.
Yep, absolutely.
Yeah, that's just fantastic, yeah, because it is all about those people from those times
that's
who set those church dances going and helped entertain people.
A celebration.
It is a celebration because we were talking to Robert Considine and he was talking...
You mean Robert was talking to us?
Yes.
He was great, buddy.
Yeah.
And he was talking about the fact that the Spencer Street dance had been there for a very, very long time, and it rang a bell for me because my grandmother used to play at the church dances out at Cust.
Goodness,
that would have been over 100 years ago.
Gosh,
and they,
wow,
how important they were to the local communities, these church dances, because it was
goodness,
the time where people could gather,
exactly right,
let their hair down and really interact and be social.
Well, my dad, Harry Bland, he had a band called Harry and the Revelers.
Well, wow, how's that? That's
piano,
great,
sax and drums. And right through from the 30s, right through to the 50s, he played in, out in the country.
So music's
Mayfield
in the family.
And, yes, well, I suppose I should have mentioned that.
In
but
the
he
genes
was a wonderful saxophonist, and he was playing right up to the age of 82 up in Auckland in the big clubs up there, just occasionally. And I, as a kid, of course, Dion, I used to lie in my bed in Wollstone, and they used to practice in the next room, piano, sax, and drums. And it was Harry Bland, Horry Ashby, and a guy called Shand, Mr. Shand.
So that obviously made an impression on a young boy at the time. Yeah, I can quite see why you gravitated there, the way your genes are going to music. That's wonderful.
Well, it's the greatest relaxation. I mean, if you've got music, whether you play a piano or play guitar or a flute, doesn't matter. The nicest thing about the second time round for me is I can leave the pressure in my office downstairs and go upstairs and sing some songs, and there's nothing like it. And I've got all this wonderful gear, and I haven't had any complaints from my neighbours in my new office yet. I've warned them occasionally, you know,
okay,
that I'm going to do a few songs. But, yeah, it's just been absolutely wonderful.
Norm, from the 60s eras up to the present time, or perhaps more in the 60s time, what would some of your favourite numbers be?
Well...
when I say numbers, songs.
Well, in those days, I was 9.5 stone. I looked a bit like Gene Pitney. Excuse me. And I sung Gene Pitney songs. In fact, I was the only guy in
24 Hours to Tulsa.
Exactly. That was the first biggie. Then songs like If I Didn't Have a Dime. I still do those
love
songs.
Them.
I used to sing Mecca. It Hurts to Be in Love. I'm doing these songs now, which is quite amazing.
There's a reasonable sort of range in some of those songs,
oh,
too.
Yes. Some of them are very demanding. There's one particular song I like to sign off on the evening. It's called Something's Gotten Hold of My Heart, and that's a very difficult song to sing, and I've got to be in a very special mood to do it. That has been sort of my identification, you might say, around Christchurch. Norm Bland sings Gene Pitney. But of course I love all the other artists, Elvis, I do Buddy Holly, I do Roy Orbison.
Yeah, I was going to say, if you did Gene Pitney, then you'd probably do a bit of Roy Orbison, wouldn't you?
Yeah.
Yes, because he has a unique voice which has a wide range as well.
Yeah.
Quite difficult to sing some of his.
So
well,
favourite songs?
Well, I would say It Hurts to Be in Love, Dream Lover.
Another good one, though. That used to rocket along, that
I
one.
I guess they're the two favourites. I've got a wonderful new disc now. Just bought another 10 songs. This is the sort of variety I've got in my repertoire. I've got a song called Frozen Orange Juice by Peter Sarstedt, I think it was. Then I've got Rocking All Over the World. And then I've got a number called Smoke on the Water. And then I've got a number called North to Alaska. I mean, this is the sort of range of songs I do, from North to Alaska to Smoke on the Water. And then I do a few Perry Como songs, plus Wasted Days and Wasted Nights. And It's All Over Now by The Stones. So,
well, that's a pretty good coverage, I'd say, of those periods of time.
Yeah, exactly. In fact, after my hard day, I actually went up and did a couple of songs just to relax a bit.
Tell me, Norm, are you 50 plus and loving it?
Mate, am I loving it? I don't feel anything, actually, Cecile. I just feel good. I am a little overweight, and I've got to attend to that. I have a little high blood pressure. I've got to attend to that. But certainly, apart from that, I really do feel good. Yeah.
It's wonderful. It's really great that you're enjoying life, because that's what life is about. It's living it.
Well, it is, and it wouldn't be possible without the wonderful support from my wife, Leslie, and my wonderful family. The second time round, it wasn't very pleasant the first time round, because I used to come home and fall in the bath. But now, there's no smoking. My wife comes out and supports me, and it really is great.
Yes, I thought I'd better clarify the second time around. We're talking the music,
yes,
aren't we? Because now, you have been married for at least 38 years.
Yes, I have. Yes, yes. 38 going on 39. Married to the same wonderful lady. Yeah.
And that's very the joy of meeting someone when you're young and spending the time together.
Yes.
Dion and I have had that the experience as well, and we've really thoroughly enjoyed it. At least I have. I hope he has.
Yeah. Well, funny enough, I met my wife up at the Copper Cat. I was singing a Gene Pitney number called I'm Going to Be Strong. Do you remember that? Very, very strong number. And all the smoke, I could see this gorgeous lady coming through the smoke towards me.
The lady of the mist.
Exactly. Just as I was hitting the great big high note, and I'm going to be strong, she came past me. Hey, that was it.
Wonderful. That's a wonderful way for us to say thank you very much for coming and sharing with us, Norm. It's been a fun experience, and Dion and I'd like to invite you back again sometime.
Well, I'd love to come, and thank you so much for having me.
It has been great to hear you talk about your love of music and those early days, and I think this is what performances are all about, the enjoyment of music and the way other people enjoy that music.
Yes.
Such a wonderful thing. Thanks very much for coming along, Norm, and yes, we're definitely going to have to get you back on again.
Thank you, Dion. Thank you, Cecile.
See you later, alligator. So long.